Now we'll look at two examples involving the zero exponent rule. In the first example, we're asked to evaluate 3x raised to the zero power if x equals 5. The first thing to recognize is that the exponent of zero is only attached to the base of x. This is the same as 3 times x raised to the power of zero. So to evaluate this, when x equals 5, we substitute 5 for x, and therefore the expression would be 3 times 5 raised to the power of 0. And 5 raised to the power of 0 is equal to 1, and therefore the expression simplifies to 3 times 1, which equals 3. Notice the expression 3x raised to the 0 power would be equal to 3 times 1, which equals 3, for any value of x, except when x equals 0, because 0 raised to the 0 power is undefined or in an indeterminate form. In the next example, we're asked to simplify t to the fifth divided by t to the fifth. And notice how we're also told t doesn't equal zero. Well, because we're dividing and the basis is the same, we apply the quotient property of exponent shown here, which states when dividing and the basis is the same, we subtract the exponents, and it's always the top exponent minus the bottom exponent. So t to the fifth divided by t to the fifth is equal to t raised to the power of 5 minus 5, which is equal to t raised to the power of 0. And t raised to the power of 0 will always be equal to 1 as long as t doesn't equal 0. Notice how we are told t doesn't equal 0. And therefore the expression simplifies to 1. And this should make sense because notice how, looking at the original problem, we have t to the fifth divided by t to the fifth. Anything divided by itself is equal to 1, as long as we don't have 0 divided by 0. This is the reason why we have the condition that t can't equal 0. I hope you found this helpful.